We'll discuss breathing systems or breathing circuits. So breathing systems or breathing circuits, and today we'll be focusing on semi-closed type of breathing systems. So breathing systems, they connect anesthesia machine to the patient for the delivery of the anesthetic gases. And they have been broadly classified as open, semi-closed and closed. So open, as the name suggests, means you directly pour over the patient mouth and nostrils. So just you can put a, it was more or less for ether. So just a wire-like mask, like a tea filter mask was there, which is placed over patient mouth and nostril. A layer of gauze paste is put and then ether was directly poured over that. So with this technique, you cannot control the depth of anesthesia. Otherwise, our newer vaporizers, they are calibrated even in points. You can calibrate the delivery of inhalational agents in points. But here, arbitrarily you keep on pouring, so you cannot control the depth of anesthesia. Moreover, the patient expires, he or she directly expires into the atmosphere, leading to a lot of theater pollution. So that is why these systems, they became obsolete. So in semi-open, what they did? They just apply a folded towel all around this mask to prevent the escape of gases, but that also didn't work, so they also become obsolete. So open and semi-open system, they are obsolete. So nowadays we are only using semi-closed and closed circuits. So the semi-closed circuits, they were described by the scientist Mapleson, so they are called as Mapleson circuits, and Mapleson have classified these circuits from A to F. So today we will be discussing these Mapleson circuits or semi-closed circuits. So Mapleson A, Mapleson A is also called as Magill circuit. Called as Magill circuit. So it is like this. This is the like this. This is the expiratory valve. This is the machine end of the circuit, and this is the patient end, and this is the breathing bag which we'll be using to ventilate the patient. Now obviously this end will be connected to the anesthesia machine, and this end will be connected to the patient either through this mask or through endotracheal tube. Now fresh gases, that means gases coming from machine, shown here as green line, that will be directly delivered to the patient. Now the expired gases, which I'm showing here as red dotted lines, most of these expired gases, they will vent out into the atmosphere through this expiratory valve. However, some of these gases will go back into the tubing. And that is why these circuits are called as semi-closed circuits, because majority of the gases are venting out into the atmosphere, while some of the gases, they go back into the tubing. Now the gases which has gone back into the tubing. So these gases which has gone back into the tubing will be re-inhaled by the patient in next breath. That is called as rebreathing. But that we never want. We never want that patient should inspire his expired gases. So aim of every circuit is that there should not be any rebreathing. And how to prevent this rebreathing? They have defined fresh gas flow. Fresh gas flow means the flow coming from anesthesia machine. So gases coming from anesthesia machine is called as fresh gas flow. So there should be sufficient fresh gas flow, which should be able to, so this fresh gas flow coming from anesthesia machine should actually be sufficient enough to push this expiratory gas out of this expiratory valve and then to be delivered to the patient. For every circuit, they have defined fresh gas flow, that if you keep this much fresh gas flow in this kind of circuit, there will not be any rebreathing. Now, how it is calculated is much beyond your scope, but you have to know for each circuit that how much fresh gas flow from machine should come, which should be able to prevent rebreathing. So fresh gas flow recommendations for McGill circuit is, if you are using it for a spontaneously breathing patient, spontaneous ventilation, which in future will be writing in a short form, then it has been seen that fresh gas flow, which I told you, fresh gas flow means the gases coming from anesthesia machine, fresh gas flow, which in future will be writing as short form FGF, should be equal to the minute volume of the patient. So fresh gas flow should be equal to the minute volume of patient for a spontaneously breathing patient. But if you use this McGill circuit for controlled ventilation, which we'll be writing in future as CV. So, what do you mean by controlled ventilation? Controlled ventilation means patient does not have spontaneous breath. You or ventilator is controlling the ventilation of the patient. Controlled means you or ventilator is controlling the ventilation of the patient. So if you use it for controlled ventilation, it has been seen that fresh gas flow requirement become very high, more than 3 times of the minute volume, which is obviously not acceptable. So therefore, McGill circuit is not recommended for controlled ventilation. Or other words, you can say that it is the circuit of choice for spontaneous ventilation. So McGill circuit is the circuit of choice for controlled ventilation, and fresh gas flow required to prevent rebreathing should be equal to minute volume, and it must not be used for controlled ventilation because fresh gas flow requirement is very high, unacceptably high. So initially, Mapleson was doing experiments. So in type B, what he did, he bought this expiratory valve from here to here, so that became a disadvantage. And in type C, what he did, he reduced the length of this tubing. Again, circuit became disadvantageous, so circuit became obsolete. So B and C are obsolete circuits. B and C are obsolete circuits. Now Mapleson D is like this. So Mapleson D as such was not a big advantage, but a modification in Mapleson D was made by scientist Bain. And what modification he made? He actually just incorporated an inner tube into this outer tube, making it as a coaxial. Coaxial means one tube passing through the other. Now fresh gases obviously will go through this inner tube, and expired gases will go through the outer tube. So point of mixing will be only here. So point of mixing became very small. So this circuit became very popular, so and so that you can say that beans will be most commonly used semi-closed circuit. And fresh gas flow recommendations for Bain circuit is, if you are using it for controlled ventilation, then fresh gas flow requirement should be 1.6 times of minute volume. However, you can also use it for a spontaneously breathing patient, but in that case fresh gas flow will be higher, and that will be 2.5 times of minute volume. So obviously a good circuit is a circuit which consumes less gases, and you can clearly see that Bain's is consuming less gases, making it as a circuit of choice for controlled ventilation. So Bain's is the circuit of choice for controlled ventilation. However, it can also be used for spontaneous ventilation, but in that case fresh gas flow should be 2.5 times of minute volume. Since Bain's was very commonly used, so people devised another method to decrease the requirement of fresh gas flow further, and that method was that they increase the respiratory rate. So if you normally we are using around 10 to 12. So if you make it around 16 to 18, it has been seen that fresh gas flow become equivalent to the minute volume, which is usually expressed as 70 to 100 ml per kg. So why I'm telling this, because in books you will find that it has been given fresh gas flow for Bain circuit being 1.6 times of minute volume, or you may also find fresh gas flow for Bain circuit being mentioned as 70 to 100 ml per kg, and both are correct and both are actually equally effective. Depending on your personal preferences, you can choose any one. So if you are using normal rate of ventilation, normal breathing rate, then fresh gas flow should be at 1.6 times of minute volume. But if you use higher respiratory rate, increased respiratory rate, then fresh gas flow becomes 70 to 100 ml per kg. So until Mapleson D, these are the adult semi-closed circuits. Mapleson E and Mapleson F are the pediatric semi-closed circuits. Mapleson E Mapleson E is just IRST piece. So it was just actually a T piece to which a breathing circuit was attached. In fact, just you can say a tubing was attached, making it as an IRST piece, but it is not a complete circuit. So it was made complete by attaching a breathing bag to it by two scientists, that is Jackson and Rees, which is also called as Mapleson F. So Jackson Rees or Mapleson F, you can say is the most commonly used, or rather only semi-closed circuit used in children less than 6 years or less than 20 kg. And fresh gas flow recommendations of Jackson Rees. Are similar to Bain's. Functionally, it behaves like Bain's. Are similar to Bain's. That means 1.6 times of minute volume for controlled ventilation and 2.5 times of minute volume for spontaneous ventilation. Now we can have just the visual impression of these circuits. So this is the Bain circuit, and you can see that this is a inner tube that's going all the way. You can see, and that is why they made actually transparent, so that you can see that by chance if tube get kinked, you can see. So up to here it is there. So this is the point where there is possibility of mixing, and expired gases will go through the outer tube. And another advantage of Bain circuit is that you can say its length very long circuit. So it will be very useful for situations like, say, neurosurgical patients where anesthetists stand much away from the patients. Then this is the Jackson Rees. So this was just an IRST piece to which a tubing was attached by IRS, then a bag was attached by Jackson Rees. So just we can summarize these Mapleson circuit. Mapleson are semi-closed. And why semi-closed, I told you, because gases are venting out into the atmosphere and some gases are being retained into the tubing, so they are called as semi-closed circuits. Fresh gas flow, spontaneous ventilation, fresh gas flow for controlled ventilation, and comments. So Mapleson A also called as Magill circuit, and it is the circuit of choice for spontaneous ventilation, and it must not be used for controlled ventilation, and the fresh gas flow required for spontaneous ventilation should be equal to the minute volume of the patient, and must not be used for controlled ventilation, because for controlled ventilation fresh gas flow requirement is very high, more than 3 times of the minute volume. Then Mapleson B and C are obsolete circuits, and reason I told you because they change the dynamics of the circuits. Then yes, another important thing I forgot to tell you in Magiel circuit is what should be the ideal position of this expiratory valve? Obviously, it should be as near as patient. So it should be as near as to patient, so that patient can expire all gases immediately into the atmosphere. So this expiratory valve should be as near as to the patient. Mapleson D, also called as, not exactly called as, but you can say a modification of Mapleson D Baines. Most commonly used. Semi-closed circuit, and it is the circuit of choice for controlled ventilation. And fresh gas flow for controlled ventilation should be 1.6 times per minute volume, and I told you it can be used for a spontaneously breathing patient, but in that case fresh gas flow will be 2.5 times of minute volume. Then Mapleson E is also called as RSTPs, and it's an incomplete circuit. Incomplete circuit, and it was made complete by attaching a breathing bag to it by scientist Mapleson. Jackson entries, in fact. Mapleson F. Is actually Jackson Rees. Actually, we called it Jackson Rees, which is loosely called as Mapleson F. So Jackson and Rees, you can say, is the most commonly used pediatric circuit to be used in children less than 6 years or less than 20 kg. And fresh gas flow recommendations of Jackson Rees are similar to Baines. That is 1.6 times for controlled ventilation and 2.5 times for spontaneous ventilation. Now we have some newer kind of semi-closed circuits also. Humphrey ADE, as the name suggests, means we have three circuits in one circuit. ADE means this circuit can work as A, D or E, means can work for spontaneous ventilation, can work for controlled ventilation, and can work for pediatric. So you need not change circuit with every patient, same circuit. Humphrey AD can be used for spontaneous ventilation, controlled ventilation, as well as pediatric age group. So it appears very promising, but there are number of tubings passing through each other, so that make it a little complicated. So actually it couldn't become very popular. Then LAC circuit. So LAC is a coaxial modification of Magiel circuit. So coaxial modification means what they did? They passed an inner tube into the Magill circuit, so that becomes lag circuit. But the difference from Bain's is, and in Bain's we have seen that inner tube is used for fresh gas flow, that is inspiratory acid, and expired tube for the outer tube for the expired gases, but it is opposite. Here what they did, inner tube was for expiratory gases, while outer tube was for inspiratory. However, they found it to be no more effective than Bain's for controlled ventilation, and rather become less effective than Magill for spontaneous ventilation. So obviously that also really couldn't become very popular. That is also hardly used. I think that should be all about these semi-closed circuits. So if you have any doubt, you can pin me through these, and if you want to subscribe the regular subscriptions, then you can use my code, that is Doctor. Ajay Yadav 0712-3233. And so by using my code, by using this code, you get flat 10% discount on your all subscriptions. And then we are coming up with a lot of programs which are very suitable for upcoming AIMS, NEET PG 2020 or PGI. So we are planning to have capsule course, test and discussion courses, which will be very useful. Then we are also planning to have a crash course, a rapid revision course, or course on the very important point, last minute revision points. So lot of short courses you are going to have in the coming 1 or 2 months till we have our NEET 2020. So you can subscribe to get the benefit of these courses, which will be very useful for you. And once you join, then you can really get a schedule also, that what courses you are going to have in November and what courses you are going to have in December. Any queries, can pin in here. And okay, then my best wishes, see you there in next class.